conscience. Why do we have one? Or do we? Our conscience tells us when we've stepped in something, but those who ignore their conscience will keep on walking, even though they have left evidence behind by their footprints. God sees it all, but many deny it all, ignoring the fact that God gave us a conscience not to ignore it, but to own up to it. If you can't hear what your conscience is saying, you have blocked God's Holy Spirit out of your life. This is defiance, and there will always be consequences when turning your heart off to God's Holy Spirit. When our conscience is being seared, our internal conversation goes like this. God, no, I don't want to change. God, no, I don't want to stop doing what I'm doing. Do you have to keep asking me? If you keep asking me, I'm going to shut you out. It's an easy thing to do, shut you out, because I've done it so many times. You don't have to warn me time and time again. I'm an adult and can take care of myself. I don't listen to you, so why should I listen to others who are trying to warn me too? Compare me to a psychopath, and you will find out I'm so much better than them. I don't do all those evil things like they do. If I decide to change, I'll let you know, and you can keep helping me if I need it, but only if I need it. I don't want your voice in my life longer than I can stand hearing the things you're calling me to do. If I don't listen, then I don't have to hear. So let's call it a day and forget that we've even had this conversation. I'd rather have my conscience seared, burnt to a crisp, than to stop sinning. I'll call you when I need you, so stand by. When our conscience is seared, it is all about us, never about God. It is no longer a conscience that desires to be right with God. Rather, it likes to be wrong with God. In fact, leave God out of the picture except when I act religious. So God is deceived into thinking I'm still on his good side. Our conscience as believers should be so sensitive to God's Holy Spirit that even the slightest sin should pierce our spirit and our hearts, knowing we do not want to hurt God or others. Our conscience should give us a red alert as God's Holy Spirit speaks loud and clear when we start walking in the flesh. If we can walk away from his voice without repentance, then we have seared our conscience. Ephesians 4:30-31. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Get rid of all bitterness, rage, and anger, brawling, and slander, along with every form of malice. It is interesting when a person who has a seared conscience gets hurt by someone, they let everyone know or they express their hurt. But when they turn their back on God to grieve him, it doesn't faze them. It's a no big deal when God gets hurt, but a big deal when they get hurt. To grieve means to mourn, have deep distress, weep, have sorrow. A conscience searer doesn't have remorse, doesn't care if God's Holy Spirit grieves, because all they care about is themselves. To top it off, they actually say no to God's Holy Spirit to continue in their world of sin. Do you have a seared conscience? Do you care to listen to God's Holy Spirit when he speaks to you about your sin? Yes, it is sin when God asks us to stop doing something or to ask forgiveness and repent. It's never too late to change, to give your life fully to God. He He is waiting. Will you obey now?